Initialize sequence now. Coming to you live from Houston, Texas, home to the world's largest medical center. This is Your Health First, the most beneficial health program on radio with Dr. JoeGalati. During the next hour, you'll learn about health, wellness, and the prevention of disease. Now, here's your host, Dr. JoeGalati.
Well, 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 a good Sunday evening to everybody. Dr. JoeGalati on this 4th of July weekend. It's a little weird this year because we've got the 4th is on Tuesday. Tomorrow's Monday. A lot of people have off. I, unfortunately, have to go to work. And it's a little bit of a disjointed. You don't get that sense of a full, long weekend, though plenty of you certainly are taking advantage and having a four-day weekend. So that's great. But I do appreciate your tuning in tonight. We are here every Sunday evening between 7 and 8 p.m. And our single-minded job is to raise your health IQ. That is it. That is all we really want to do here. If we accomplish that every week, we're fine. We go home happy and get ready for the next week. To contact us, to be part of the program, drjoegalati.com is our website. Most important thing, sign up for our newsletter. There's a tab at the top of the page. There's a contact us tab if you want to send me a message. And we are going to be hearing from a listener, a follower of ours in the next segment. Paul called, reached out, had a heart disease question. He went for a test and got an abnormal result. So we're going to hear his story, share that with you. And then a little later on the program, we have Dr. Mike Wilson, James Wilson, Dr. James Michael Wilson, a cardiologist. He's been on the program before, and he will try to talk us through the general things all of you need to think about when it comes to heart health. And of course, all of our social media is posted on drjoegalati.com. One thing that I don't talk about too much, there is a clinical assessment. I hate to say clinical. It makes it sound too medical. It's an assessment. It's a 10-point questionnaire that you could take on the website, which will give you a sense of where you are at with your health and wellness. And it's a good inventory to take. So don't, when you go to the website, it says assessment, you can take it and get a sense of where you're at. So coming up, Dr. Wilson, our listener Paul will be telling us his own health journey in a sense. Two articles that I, well, really three articles that I have to chat about now. And I will post these after the show on the Facebook page. It has to do with artificial sweeteners and cancer. Now, for those of you that are old enough, back into the 60s, the wild 60s, saccharin, which was probably one of the first readily available artificial sweeteners, there was always concern that this was going to cause cancer. And there was some concern that it caused bladder cancer. But numerous studies have been done and basically cleared saccharin of that concern. And now we have back in the news the World Health Organization. Aspartame. Right, that is equal. They are, in the very near future, going to put a warning on products that that contain aspartame. That it is, now this is the wording, possibly carcinogenic to humans. Now, when you look at the International Agency for Research on Cancer, they analyze a lot of these products and they give recommendations to consumers and governments and manufacturers and the pharmaceutical industry. There's basically three levels. Possibly carcinogenic. The second is probably carcinogenic. And the last one is carcinogenic to humans. And so this is the big concern here. Now, the one thing that they are lacking is they do not state in any of their research the amount of aspartame that you need to eat to put you at risk for cancer. The general consensus is if you consume a lot, you're at risk for certain cancers. Now, is that a 6-pack of Diet Coke? Is it a 12-pack? Is it 87 pieces of sugar-free gum? So they don't really say how much you need to consume here. But the one thing that I would look at, and when you do look at the literature, there really is not a lot of cancer data that has been reported. But I would look at it to say all of these foods and products that have these artificial sweeteners, whether it is Splenda or Equal or saccharin, you're eating processed foods. And so you have to look at it and say, if I am eating a food or a diet that is high in all of these various sweeteners, yeah, you know, there may be a risk of cancer, that though that may be quite low. But really, you want to stay away from all of these processed foods, which will lead to obesity and diabetes and hypertension, heart disease, cancer, all of that. The other two stories real quick is Ireland is getting into the act here. They are putting cancer warnings on beer and wine because of the risk of cancer and liver disease. So stay tuned for that. That is going to create a large amount of fireworks, no pun intended, with the 4th of July here, with regard to putting these warnings on various bottles of alcohol. And we could talk about that a little bit more next week, because this is something I just wanted to get out there to say in the news, it's going to be talked about. And the last thing on a good point, there is evidence, and I would say we've known about this for a while, that short daytime naps are good for your brain as it ages. And so if you look at the flip side of this, people that do not get enough sleep are at risk for hypertension, worsening diabetes, heart disease, sudden cardiac death. And so if we can pay more attention to our sleep and taking a nap, you know who invented the term catnap? Thomas Edison, the inventor. He was a big proponent of taking naps in the middle of the day. But anyway, I think we have to look at our lifestyle. How crazy are we running around? We have to think about our health. All right, we're going to take a quick break. I am hopeful that we have Paul on the line. We'll be with him in a moment. I'm Dr. Joe Galati. Every Sunday between 7 and 8 p.m., go to drjoegalati.com. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.